Hi students, welcome to Diamond Group of Initiation KSET and NEET online classes. So yesterday we have completed the general principles of isolation of elements. Here the D and A block elements. Okay. In this, the first question, which one of the elements with the following outer orbital configuration may exhibit the largest number of oxidation states? Okay, again the question is, which one of the elements with the following outer orbital configuration? So they are given here outer orbital configuration. Okay, outer orbital configuration may exhibit the largest number of oxidation states. Option A 3d5 4s1, option B 3d5 4s2, option C 3d2 4s2, option D 3d3 4s2. We already know the D block elements, it has some different characters when compared with S block and P block elements. So in that, one of the different characters, D block element, they shows the variable oxidation state. Okay, so they shows the variable oxidation state because of they have a greater number of valency electrons. Okay, in their outer electronic configuration, they have the greater number of valency electron. Due to that, D block elements, they shows a variable oxidation state. For this question, here in this, in element, if greater the number of valency electrons are present, in an element, if the greater number of valency electrons are present, it will show number of oxidation states. Okay, it will show the number of oxidation states. For example, option A, go to option A. What is electron outer electronic configuration here? 3d5 4s1. So 5 1, so can show maximum 6 oxidation states. And option B 3d5 4s2, 5 2 7, therefore it shows maximum 7 oxidation state number. Option C 3d2 4s2, 2 2 4, so therefore it shows maximum oxidation number 4 for C option. And for D option, 3d3 4s2, therefore 3, 2, 5. Therefore, maximum oxidation number is 5. That means what? This is the outer electronic configuration. This is the outer electronic configuration for element. In element, if it has a greater number of valence electrons, it has a greater number of valence electrons. Therefore, it shows the maximum number of oxidation states. So, option B, here greater number of valence electrons are present. That is 3d5 4s2, therefore maximum number of oxidation states are possible 7. So B is the correct option. Next, question number 2. Lanthanides do not show +4 oxidation state in which of the following configurations? Lanthanides, they do not show +4 oxidation state in which of the following configurations? Lanthanides means 4s series elements, A block elements. Okay, so here those A block elements, they do not show +4 oxidation state in which of the following configuration? So option A F0, B F7, C F14, D all of these. Among these 4 configuration, in which of the configuration lanthanides, they doesn't show +4 oxidation state? That is the question. Okay, in lanthanide, the differentiating electron which it is enter into 4f series, I mean 4f orbital, we already known about that. In lanthanide, the differentiating electron which it is enter into 4f orbital. So we have a some rule, that is, if orbital contains full filled electron or half filled electron, then those orbitals are stable electronic configurations. Here f orbital, the maximum number of electrons in f orbital 14. Okay, the maximum number of electrons in f orbital 14. So f14 configuration is stable. Or half filled electronic configuration means 14/2, that is 7. Okay, right. So half filled electronic configuration, it is also stable electronic configuration. So F0 also stable electronic configuration. So therefore F0, F7, F14. These are the stable electronic configuration. So hint is, lanthanide does not show plus 4 oxidation state in any of the following configuration. So lanthanide does not show plus 4 oxidation state in any of the following configurations because these all these configurations are stable. F0 configuration is stable, F7 off-filled electronic configuration is stable, F14 full-filled electronic configuration also stable. So therefore, these configurations are stable configuration. Due to that, these a block element, they doesn't show the plus 4 oxidation state. Therefore, among these four, D is correct answer. Okay, all of these configuration does not show plus 4 oxidation state due to the stable configuration. Next question number 3, consider the following ion, option 1, nickel plus 2, 2, cobalt plus 2, 3, chromium plus 2, fourth one, Fe plus 3. And given atomic number for chromium 24, iron 26, cobalt 27, nickel 28. The question is what? What is the correct order of magnetic momentum of this ion? Magnetic momentum of this ion. What is the correct order of magnetic momentum of this ion? That is the question. So A, B, C, D, they are given like this. See here, four elements, nickel plus 2, cobalt plus 2, chromium plus 2, iron plus 3. Four elements. So we already know magnetic moment is depend upon number of unpaired electrons. Okay, number of unpaired electrons. So therefore, here magnetic moment is depend upon number of unpaired electrons. Therefore, first we have to find out number of unpaired electrons in nickel plus 2, cobalt plus 2, chromium plus 2 and Fe plus 3. So first one, nickel plus 2. Nickel plus 2, nickel atomic number is 28. Okay, 28. So therefore, 3d8, 4s2 is electronic configuration. Nickel atomic number 28, therefore 3d8, 4s2 electronic configuration. But here, nickel in plus 2 oxidation state, therefore, loss of 2 electrons from 4s orbital, therefore 3d8, 4s0 electronic configuration. So 3d8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, therefore 2 unpaired electrons in nickel plus 2. Next, cobalt plus 2. So cobalt atomic number 27. So actual atomic number 27 and its electronic configuration 3d7 and 4s2. But cobalt in plus 2 oxidation state, therefore loss of 2 electrons from 4s orbital, therefore cobalt plus 2 electronic configuration 3d7, 4s0. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So unpaired electrons are 1, 2, 3. 3 unpaired electrons. Next, chromium plus 2. So chromium plus 2, chromium atomic number is 24. Okay, chromium atomic number is 24 and it has a special electronic configuration to get the stability, that is 4s1 3d5. Okay, 4s1 3d5. But chromium here plus 2 oxidation state, therefore loss of 2 electrons, 1 electron from 4s orbital, 1 electron from 3d orbital. Therefore chromium plus 2 electronic configuration is 3d4. So number of unpaired electrons 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 unpaired electrons in chromium plus 2. And fourth one Fe plus 3. So iron atomic number is 26. Therefore electronic configuration, valence electronic configuration 3d6, 4s2. But Fe in plus 3 oxidation state, therefore 2 electrons from s orbital, 1 electron from d orbital is lost. Therefore Fe plus 3 electronic configuration 3d5, 4s0. 3d5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, unpaired electrons. So once you observe from nickel plus 2 to Fe plus 3, from nickel plus 2 to Fe plus 3, unpaired electron numbers are increases 2, 3, 4, 5. So here question is, what magnetic moment order of this ion? Magnetic moment is depend upon what? Unpaired electrons. So as we move from top to bottom, 2, 3, 4, 5, unpaired electrons are increases. As unpaired electrons are increases, magnetic moment also increases. Therefore, among these four, nickel plus 2, cobalt plus 2, chromium plus 2, Fe plus 3, here Fe plus 3 has maximum number of unpaired electrons. therefore it has more magnetic moment. First to fourth one, next to third one, second one, and least one. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so 4, 3, 2, 1. Option A. 4, 3, 2, 1. Option A is correct. Fourth question: the number of d electrons in Fe+2. Here, atomic number of Fe is 26. Is not equal to that of the option A, p electrons in chloride ion, and p electrons in Na+ ion, s electrons in magnesium, and p electrons in Ar. First, what is the question here? The number of d electrons in Fe+2, it is not equal to either A or B or C or D. That is the question. So first, we have to find out number of d electrons in Fe+2. Okay, so Fe, iron atomic number is 26. Therefore, electronic configuration argon 3d6 4s2. But here Fe in +2 oxidation state. Therefore, argon 3d6 4s0. Therefore, in Fe+2, number of d electrons are 6. Okay, number of d electrons are 6. Question is what? The number of d electrons in Fe+2. So the number of d electrons in Fe+2 is not equal to what? So p electrons in chloride minus. Next we have to find out p electrons in Cl- Ir. So chloride atomic number is 17. But here chloride, it is in -1 oxidation state. Therefore, number of electrons are 18. Therefore, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Here, p electrons in Cl-. So, 2p6, 6 electrons. 3p6, 6 electrons. So, p electrons in chloride minus 12 p electrons. Next, Na, p electrons in Na+. Sodium atomic number 11, but sodium here +1 oxidation state means number of electrons 10. Therefore, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. P electrons in Na+, here P electrons in Na+, 6. Okay, 6. Next, third one, S electrons in magnesium. Magnesium atomic number is 12, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. So s orbital electron, we have to find out s orbital electrons in magnesium. So 2, 2, 2, 6 electrons, s orbital electrons, 2, 2, 2, 6 electrons, 6 s orbital electrons in magnesium. Fourth one, p electrons in neon. So neon, electronic atomic number 10, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 is electronic configuration, and p orbital electrons are 6. So therefore, our Fe+2 d orbital electrons 6, and option D, neon 6 p electrons, magnesium 6 s electrons, and sodium plus 6 p electrons, 6, 6, 6, 6, it is equal. But in Fe+2, number of d electrons is not equal to chloride p electrons, chloride ion p electrons, because of in chloride ion p electrons are 12. But in our Fe+2, d electrons are 6. Therefore, it is not equal to chloride ion. Chloride ion is p electrons. So next, question number 5. Lanthanides are. So question is about lanthanides. Lanthanides are, option A, 14 elements in 6th period. Atomic number 90 to 103. And that are filling in 4s sublevel. Option B, 14 elements in 7th period, atomic number 90 to 103, that are filling in 5s sublevel. Option C, 14 elements in 6th period, atomic number 58 to 71, that are filling in 4s sublevel. Option D, 14 elements in 7th period, atomic number 50 to 71, that are filling in 4F sub level. This is previous KSET question. Okay. So here about question is about lanthanides. So lanthanides are, we already know lanthanides are a block element. So this is the periodic table, F block, P block, D block and F block. Total number of here, so total number of periods are 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 periods. Here, in 6th period, this is the lanthanum. Lanthanum belongs to D block element, atomic number 57. After 57, next to 58th element is cerium. So, 58th element is cerium. From 58 to atomic number 71, lutetium. From 58 to atomic number 71, lutetium. In this element, the differentiating electron is enter into 4s series. So therefore, cerium to lutetium elements are belongs to 4s elements. And in this 4s series, we have 14 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 elements from cerium to lutetium. Therefore, lanthanides are here, lanthanides, 4F series elements are also called lanthanides because of these elements are started after the lanthanum element. So, lanthanum belongs to D block element, atomic number 57, next to 58th element is cerium. That cerium element belongs to a block element. So from cerium to lutetium, atomic number 71. So these elements are belongs to 4F series element. These 4F series elements also called as a lanthanides. Next to 72 elements is 72. Atomic number 72 element is hafnium. That is D block element. So here about the lanthanides. So how many lanthanide elements here? 14 lanthanide elements. And in these 14 lanthanides, the differentiating electron is entered into what? 4F sublevel. Okay, 4F sublevel. And these 4F sublevel are lanthanide elements which are present in which period? 6th period. Because of in 6th period, after lanthanum element, next here we have 14 4F block, 4F series elements. So therefore, lanthanides are 6th period elements. And 4F sublevel from cerium to lutetium, atomic number 58 to 71. That is the information about lanthanides. Therefore, lanthanides are first option, 14 elements. Yes, lanthanides are 14 elements in the 6th period. But atomic number 90 to 103, this is wrong. Because of in lanthanides, atomic number 58 to 71. Next. So, B, option B, 14 elements in 7th period. That is wrong. Because of 14 elements in 7th period are actinides. But here our lanthanides are 14 elements in 6th period. 14 elements in 6th period. Therefore, B option also wrong option. Go to C, 14 elements in 6th period. Yes, 14 elements in 6th period. 14 elements in 6th period. Atomic number 58 to 71. And that are filling in 4F sublevel, that are filling in 4F sublevel. Therefore, option C is correct. Option D, 14 elements in 7th period. So, that is wrong information. Therefore, lanthanides are 14 elements in 6th period. Atomic number 58 to 71 means cerium to lutetium, that are filling in 4F sublevel. Next, question number 6. Which of the following is arranged in order of decreasing thermal stability? So the question is about thermal stability. Okay, thermal stability and decreasing order of thermal stability of the following elements. So here in option A, B, C, D, once you observe, so comparing in between zinc, cadmium, mercury. So zinc, cadmium, mercury, thermal stability order. So they are asking about thermal stability order. Here, zinc, cadmium, mercury, they belong to D block elements. Zinc, cadmium, mercury, they belong to D block elements. So, from top to bottom, in this zinc, cadmium, mercury, from top to bottom, melting point values is decreases. smelting point value from zinc to mercury, zinc, cadmium, mercury. From zinc to mercury, melting point value decreases. That means zinc has more melting point than cadmium and mercury. So here it is what melting point of zinc, cadmium, mercury follows. Zinc is more melting point than the cadmium and mercury. So here higher the melting point of zinc. So if the melting point is more, higher the melting point, higher will be the thermal stability. If the melting point is more, thermal stability is also more. So here comparison is zinc, cadmium, mercury. In between zinc, cadmium, mercury. So zinc, cadmium, mercury from top to bottom, melting point values are decreases. Means zinc has more melting point. So if the melting point is more, thermal stability is also more. So higher the melting point, higher will be the thermal stability. Therefore, order of thermal stability is zinc is more thermal stable than cadmium and mercury because of zinc has more melting point. Okay, so therefore zinc, cadmium, mercury. Option C, zinc more thermal stable than cadmium and mercury due to the more melting point of zinc. So next question number 7, which of the following compounds has color but no unpaired electrons? Which of the following compounds has color but no unpaid electrons? That is the question. Option A, KMnO4. Option B, K2MnO4. Option C, MnSO4. Option D, MnCl2. So here, which of the following compound is color but no unpaid electron? So first we have to find out the unpaid electrons in KMnO4. Option A, in KMnO4, the manganese is in +7 oxidation state. Okay, so we have here some rules to find out the oxidation number of a particular element. So here manganese, so it is in +7 oxidation state. So manganese atomic number is 25. Okay, therefore outer electronic configuration argon 4s2 3d5. But here manganese in +7 oxidation state, therefore it loses 7 electrons from s orbital and d orbital of the outer shell. Therefore manganese +7 oxidation state electronic configuration argon 3d0 4s0. Actually manganese atomic number is 25 and its electronic configuration 4s2 3d5. But in KMnO4 manganese present in +7 oxidation state. Therefore, +7 oxidation state electronic configuration 3d0 4s0. Okay, 3d0 4s0. So therefore here there is no unpaired electron. There is no unpaired electron, but still KMnO4 present in dark pink color. KMnO4 present in dark pink color. So question is what here? Which of the following compounds has color but no unpaired electron? KMnO4 present in dark pink color, but there is no unpaired electron. Therefore, option A is correct answer. Next, question number 8. Wrong statement for a block element is what? Okay, so wrong statement for a block element. So first, option A, common oxidation state is +3. So here a block element common oxidation state is +3. For example, lanthanide. In lanthanide they show +3 oxidation state by the removing of 2 electrons from 6s orbital and 1 electron from 4s orbital. So for example, lanthanide they show +3 oxidation state by the removing of 2 electrons from 6s orbital, 1 electron from 4f orbital. So it shows the +3 oxidation state. And here it is difficult to remove more number of electrons from 4f orbital. What is the reason? Because of high energy differences between 6s orbital and 4f orbital. So here, high energy difference in between 6s orbital and 4f orbital, due to that, it is difficult to remove more number of electrons from 4f orbital. Therefore, common aspiration state is plus 3. This is the correct statement. And second one, actinides are more reactive than lanthanides. Okay. So, in a black element, we have 4F series elements and 5F series elements. 4F series elements are called lanthanides. 5F series elements are called actinides. So, here actinides are more reactive. Actinides are more reactive than lanthanides. Because of lanthanides have small atomic size than the actinides. So, lanthanides have small atomic size than the actinides. Therefore, actinides are more reactive than lanthanides. And partially filled F orbital responsible for color. Next, D, in lanthanides, electrons enter into 5f orbital. This is the wrong statement. Okay, in lanthanides, electrons enter into 5f orbital. Because in lanthanides, differentiating electrons enter into 4f subshell. But in actinides, differentiating electrons enter into 5f subshell. So therefore, in lanthanides, electrons enter into 4f orbital. If it is 4f orbital, correct statement. But here, in lanthanides, electrons enter into 5f orbital. Therefore, this is the wrong statement. So, question is what? Wrong statement for a block element. Option D. Next, question number 9. The metals present in insulin. The central metals are present in insulin, hemoglobin, and vitamin B12. So, which metals are present in insulin, hemoglobin, vitamin B12? That is the question. So, insulin, hemoglobin, vitamin B12. Here, insulin, it contains central element is zinc. And in hemoglobin, so it is present in blood. So, in hemoglobin, the central element is iron. Vitamin B12, that is also called cyanocobalamin, in that the central element is cobalt. Therefore, insulin contains zinc, hemoglobin iron, vitamin B12 cobalt. Therefore, option D is correct. Next, 10th question here. So, standard electrode potential values for the couples of chromium plus 3 to chromium plus 2, and manganese plus 3 to manganese plus 2 are minus 0.41. These are standard electrode potential values for couples of chromium plus 3 and chromium plus 2 and manganese plus 3 to manganese plus 2. Minus 0.41 and plus 1.51 volts respectively. Based on these values are suggest that what? Okay, so question is, standard electrode potential values for the couples of chromium plus 3 by chromium plus 2 is minus 0.41 and Mn plus 3 by Mn plus 2 is plus 1.51. So based on these values, what is this suggest? That is the question. Option A, chromium plus 2 act as a reducing agent and Mn plus 3 act as an oxidizing agent. Option B, chromium plus 2 is more stable than chromium plus 3. Option C, Mn plus 3 is more stable than Mn plus 2. Option D, Cr plus 2 act as a oxidizing agent and Mn plus 3 act as a reducing agent. So, here this is a hint. In EMF series, from top to bottom, standard reduction potential values are decreases. Okay, so for example, here element is present, means here element is present means that element has more standard reduction potential values. Means for this element, standard reduction potential values in positive. So if the element has positive standard reduction potential values, then it undergoes reduction. Reduction means what? By the here gain of electrons. And next term, standard reduction potential values, if in top element it has more positive means more standard deduction potential value means it is undergoes reduction. If it is undergoes reduction, if this element undergoes reduction, means that element acts as a oxidizing agent. Okay, that element acts as a oxidizing agent. Next, from top to bottom, standard deduction potential values are decreases, means from positive to zero and zero to negative. Means the down element in EMF series, the down element which it is having negative standard deduction potential value. So negative standard deduction potential value, if the element has negative standard deduction potential value, then it is undergoes oxidation. If the element has negative standard deduction potential value, then it is undergoes oxidation. That means here this element acts as a reducing agent. Okay, it is act as a reducing agent. So this is the hint. So positive standard deduction potential value act as a oxidizing agent. Positive standard deduction potential value element act as a oxidizing agent. Negative standard deduction potential value element act as a reducing agent. So here negative. So negative value. So here standard deduction potential value negative means that is act as a reducing agent. Okay, that is act as a reducing agent. Therefore, here chromium plus 3, chromium plus 2, standard deduction potential value is negative. Means here it is act as a reducing agent. Therefore, chromium plus 2 act as a reducing agent, right? Because negative value. Next, Mn plus 3, Mn plus 2 standard deduction potential values are positive. So positive. So if the standard deduction potential values are in positive, then that is act as a oxidizing agent. Therefore, Mn plus 3, Mn plus 2 standard deduction potential value positive means it is act as Mn plus 3 act as a oxidizing agent. Therefore, option A is correct for 10th question.